All right, so we're back once again, guys. Again, this is the Garena Premier League 2017. I'm Astor Ryan. Here with me is Iconic. And what a game one that was.
Exactly.
I mean, really can't, what do you call this? Ignore the fact that it was a remake.
Yeah.
That second game one was kind of, I don't know, it just felt like Mineski were kind of trying too hard.
Yeah, one of the things that you can't avoid is technical difficulties. It is actually a part of, you know, competitive play. Some things you just can't avoid. So
yeah,
it was kind of disheartening for Mineski having to remake after coming out from a really big lead that first game before it was remade. But they actually did pretty well last game.
Yeah, that was actually pretty good. I mean, James was all over the place. I mean, not all over the place that it was bad. It was all over the place that was, you know, he was getting kills, putting pressure on the lanes, which was also nice.
Exactly. And that Baron smite that actually got them the Baron, even though it was a bad Baron call,
yeah,
they were still able to secure the Baron and actually hold out a little bit longer.
All right, so, I mean, aside from, you know, looking into game one, there was a lot of good plays for Ascension's side and then Mineski. What do you think, like, Ascension needs to do to maybe get a smoother early game for themselves? Because that's, I think, what they kind of lacked. But then Mineski had a much more, I think, like, drastic drop in performance in the late game.
What's actually interesting was that Mineski changed their play style and Ascension wasn't ready for it. As you could see during the first game, it was a very unlikely gank at mid, but it still happened and Ascension didn't expect it. That's why G4 actually paid the price in mid lane. But if they try to figure out like where the jungler actually starts, like where the James starts or where Nyxta will start, they will actually have a better understanding of where the jungler might gank first, and that will help Ascension not give up first blood that easily.
So, you know, early wardings invades into the jungle of your opponent, getting that early scout off, definitely going to be important here for Ascension, just to spot out, you know, because right now I've seen, like, I think it's almost all junglers here in the GPL who are just, like, super aggressive. They're going to go for just the all-out ganks in the early game.
Yeah, exactly. One of the things that Southeast Asia has that not a lot of regions have is crazy aggressive junglers where they actually trust their team to back them up all the time, and sometimes it doesn't actually pan out as well as it plans, but if they do execute it pretty well, they can start to get the ball rolling for a lane, and it'll start snowballing for their team.
Yeah, I mean, it just snowballs into a huge lead, and then, you know, nobody can stop them. I think, like, when I watched the Thailand finals with, I think that was Ascension and Bangkok Titans, that was where Ascension Gaming was on top. Like, every time I saw Viper just going in, it was G4, you know, picking up the slack with the Orianna, with the Victor, with the Jace, just everything. And then let's just see how Mineski can actually counter that out, because there was, like, this one game, I think that was yesterday with Fortius Gaming, wherein Exo actually went for a Twisted Fate. He was trying to make a lot of plays, but then I guess it was just, like, bad clarity of, like, how much mana he has, because every time he Destiny's in, he had no mana at all.
Yeah, so, like, that Twisted Fate pick didn't actually work. So if they do pick Twisted Fate to get up against Ascension, I'm sure Ascension will actually know how to deal with it, because one of the reasons why Twisted Fate doesn't see a lot of play anymore is he's easily countered by good teamwork, good communication, and as we saw in the previous game, Ascension Gaming actually have really good teamwork, where they know when just to let Lloyd keep on split pushing, attract all the pressure, and sadly Mineski couldn't do anything about it, and Mineski got so impatient that they started the Baron, which resulted in their loss.
That's true. But of course, while we are still waiting for the drafting phase to go, we'll just show you an interview, guys, of our players here. So here it is.
ผมตอบว่าถ้าไม่มั่นใจผมคงไม่มาที่นี่หรอกพรุ่งนี้ที่ผมต้องเจอ EXO SCENE พรุ่งนี้จะเป็นยังไงหรอครับเอาจริงก็ยังไม่รู้จักเขาเท่าไหร่เลยทำไมทีมผมถึงจะชนะ Mineski พรุ่งนี้หรอครับน่าจะเป็นเพราะการฝึกซ้อมที่แบบฝึกมาด้วยกันอะไรเงี้ยครับมากกว่าเพราะว่าซ้อมมาเยอะมาก
excited na nervous. Siyempre, may experience din si G4. Alam ko, nakatapat niya na si Faker, kaya alam ko magaling siya, so hindi ko na siya underestimate. Confident kaming makakalaban namin yung Ascension bukas, kasi marami kaming champion na pwedeng gamitin. Pero ang lamang namin sa Ascension is marami na kaming pinagdaan ng adversity, so alam na namin yung mga dapat namin gawin. Tapos, yung team bonding namin, yung trust sa isa't isa, sobrang laki, kaya yun lang.
Wow, so, you know, we wouldn't be comfortable if you weren't respective of Benesic to actually come in the turf. You're in our turf now.
Yeah.
But of course, they got game one, and now we're going to be starting game two drafting phase. Benesic's going to be on the blue team, and of course, if it's not going to be 100% ban, it's going to be 100% pick, Camille.
Camille, yeah. So Camille's super strong in 7.6. They didn't nerf. The nerf from 7.7 haven't implemented yet, so super strong in the current meta, and can actually fulfill the position of Fiora as well. They don't want Lloyd's hands on that Camille.
Yeah, we saw how strong he was when it was that match between Bangkok Titans. Ash, to be followed up here. So, no way. Not going to be able to have his hands on the Frost Archer.
Yeah, as the Jhin ban coming out from Ascension. They don't want Zensha on that Jhin at all. After his performance the last few days.
Yeah, this is like... I think I saw the social media posts of the Mineski members. They were like, the one trick pony, Zensha on a Jhin.
But Zensha has been doing pretty well even with other
champions
of course. Well.
It's just like, it was just like a joke that they were passing because he was like just totally dominating on the Jhin. Rengar, so not really too much difference here or like big bans. It's all standard. First pick for Mineski here is going to be the Malzahar for TG.
Very smart, actually, because they know that Lulu is banned. So Malzahar is pretty strong when Lulu is out of the picture, because Lulu can actually deal with the Voidling super easily with her empowered auto attacks from picks. So it actually doesn't give away that much as well on what Mineski wants to build on.
Yeah, and it looks like Ascension here just to counter maybe the aggressive combo of possibly a Malzahar Varus. They immediately took Varus for no way.
Yeah, because Ash is also banned away, so one of the champions that you want with the utility AD carry is the Varus, so they take it away straight up from Mineski.
Yeah, and to complement that in the bottom lane, it's going to be, well, Warlock playing the Zyra, and of course, Mineski has done wonders with this one. James yet again on the Kha'Zix. I think Ascension still hasn't thought of it as too much of a threat, so they're just letting it slip away in this first picking phase for Mineski.
Yeah, but what's interesting here is that they aren't actually... The Ascension Gaming didn't actually ban out the Warwick during the first rotation when they did the last game. So does that mean that Lloyd is actually gaining confidence against Kaigu and is willing to let them pick the Warwick? But sadly, we didn't see it this first pick rotation, but still, yeah. It is still up there.
I think Mineski is just going to be looking for possibly the more... Stabler champions for now, and then just decide if they want to go for that top lane Warwick. And at the same time, I mean, just at the start of that best of five, I mean, the game one, maybe the confidence for Lloyd. But then it is the Gragas versus the Fiora. I mean, that's not really a heavy solo top intensive matchup. So I don't know what Ascension are thinking about that.
Yeah, but the Rumble banned out because with how the meta is shaped towards team fights. Rumble is one of the best top laners now.
True,
like I like that Ascension Gaming already banned it out. Kennen is also banned out because Kennen on hit, Kennen is actually a super strong split pusher as well, which plays to the attributes of Lloyd as a top laner.
So we'll just see. I mean, Lloyd definitely looking for those top lane heavy impact champions. The more on damage, the better. But then still, look at this. Mid lane... bans have not actually been touched at all. So there's a Syndra, there's a Norianna, possibly even a Vladimir here for maybe G4.
Exactly. One of the things that the 7.6 brings to the table is super healthy mid lane and top lane champion pools. So even with these four bans, it doesn't really mean that much because there are so many alternatives, like a Kled, for example, super strong at skirmishing, dueling 1v1, and does super well against melee matchups. So what will... what will Mineski be bringing to the table?
That. I mean, how about you, in your opinion? What is a good counter to Akled?
Warwick does pretty well against Akled, actually. Warwick does pretty well, as well as another option would be the Fizz. Fizz also does pretty well against Akled. So there are a lot of options right now for Mineski's top laner. They already lock in the Echo for the mid lane because we don't see top lane Echo anymore.
Yeah, curiously enough, these are like champions who are viable in terms of, you know, if a player uses them and then uses them in the lane. But then at the same time, if I remember the stats that I saw correctly before, there was only maybe less than 50% pick rate overall in Echo in all of like the regions, and then for Akled it's like less than 5%.
Yeah, because Akled is actually a very, hasn't seen that much play aside from in NALCS where CLG ran it, and there isn't that much room for error for Akled. If you don't get a really good laning phase and bully your laner, you're gonna have a really hard time.
Yeah, and it seems that Lloyd might actually be in a bit of a pickle here, as it's going to be Kaigu with the Fizz top lane.
Exactly.
So,
Fizz top lane does pretty well against Akled. And the reason why they chose the Echo is Echo and Orianna are the most blind pickable mid laners right now in 7.6. So what you can expect from Ascension Gaming is very heavy AD. Like, only the Nidalee and the Zyra will be bringing magic damage to the table. But what I like about this the composition of Ascension Gaming, they win the game from level 1. But they descale really, really hard into the late game, as compared to Mineski's composition, where they have a super strong AD carry, a super strong mid laner, and a super strong top laner. But I'd like to talk about is Fizz actually getting Ignite.
Well, we have seen it before. I mean, when TG was top lane before for Mineski, he actually got that teleport Ignite combo. So, you know, having, I guess, the extra kill potential with the burn is kind of good.
Yeah, which is interesting because some top laners in the LCK have opted to not get the Ignite, but instead go for Flash instead. So it's just you can expect a lot of early aggression coming out from Kaigu in the top lane.
Yeah.
And it's super strong against remounting Akled because he will apply a DOT onto Akled, and his base HP on Akled is super low because it doesn't scale with bonus HP.
Yeah. And there you have it, guys. Our lineup for game 2. Mineski bringing out, or actually having no stops at all in the picks, and Ascension might be in a little bit of a pickle here, as there is, of course, the Fizz, the Echo, as well as, of course, as Ezreal to be worrisome. But, of course, Ascension do have the Jace as well as the Akled, even the Nidalee to an extent, and, of course, that Varus.
One thing that also interesting was that Viper, compared to James during the first game, Viper was super, super focused on counter jungling instead, while James was the one who's super aggressive. So that is the matchup to see right now.
All right. So we'll be showing to you guys a little bit of a matchup video. So be sure to check that out. Hashtag MSKWin, hashtag ASCWin. The Summoner's Rift back at it again for game 2, Mineski versus Ascension Gaming. So let's have a rundown of our players as we're waiting again, guys. Hashtag MSKWin for that Filipino pride, and of course, if you're a fan of G4 or the other members of Ascension Gaming, hashtag ASCWin. Let's have it here for Mineski on the blue team, Kaigu in the top lane with the Fizz. Hame is going to be on the, hold that thought, it's going to just be a little bit of a tussle between Lloyd and Kaigu. All right, so Ham is going to be on the Kha'Zix, Exozen, or Exo, going to be on that Echo bottom lane duo with Zensha and TG playing the Ezreal as well as the Malzahar.
And for Ascension Gaming, we have ASC Lloyd on the top lane Akled, ASC Viper on the jungle Nidalee, ASC G4 on the mid lane Jace. And for the further bottom lane, we have ASC No Way and ASC Warlock on the Varus and the Zyra respectively.
All right, so earlier this game, looking at where these junglers are going to be starting, or at least just, you know, how this early game is going to be panning out, which lane would you think is going to be primal here for either team to actually focus on to get an advantage.
Actually, I feel like ASC already has the advantage just by how the lanes have started. As you can see, they have no idea where... They have an idea. Mineski has an idea of where Viper started, which is Raptors, because both lanes did show up. Both top lane and bottom lane of Ascension did show up early. So they should have an idea of where the Nidalee started, but they don't know if the Nidalee actually is going to go for red first or go towards Raptors, Wolves, blue. So they have no information whatsoever where Viper will start as compared to Ascension, where they know that as a Kha'Zix, you can only start blue or red. Blue, Wolves, red, or red, blue, Wolves, blue. Because Raptors hurt too much and Krogs take way too long to take as a Kha'Zix.
Yeah,
so
there's no spamming skill, so it's kind of obvious where he's going to be starting from.
Exactly. So as you can see, Lloyd already shoving the wave in. He's going to have that wave reset back into the middle of the lane, but he knows that the right side is actually the stronger side. That's why he's pushing the wave in super early so that it'll start pushing back towards him, so that it'll be safe for him from any jungle ganks.
Yeah, definitely. Kind of learned that, you know, when starting to play as a solo top, having that lane equilibrium is very important. So just you don't overextend and kind of like, you know, keep yourself vulnerable in the top lane for too long of an extended period. So you're gonna see a little bit of a ping here, and Viper actually connecting a spear, looking into James, but not gonna decide to actually go in aggressive. So G4 versus EXO with the Echo and the Jace. What do you think about this matchup?
EXO is actually doing pretty well in this matchup because he is only three CS behind, possibly 3 CS to if he gets those 3 minions. Usually as a Jace, you'd want to push your lead in really, really hard, so you'd expect to be like 10 CS ahead. So EXO is holding on there. He has lost all his potions. Also Zensho in the bottom side, he also used his potions as well, taking a bad trade. So it's very scary right now for Mineski, because as we talked about earlier in the matchups, Ascension win from level 1 up to the mid game. So if Mineski will be at a deficit in all lanes, you can expect that. Maybe a chance of being even in the top lane, but it's up to James to actually alleviate some of the pressure, and it's up to Viper to actually choose which lane he can snowball off of, because all three lanes are winning lanes. He has the initiative to either counter jungle against James or score first blood.
Yeah, true that. Kaigu, some fancy footwork in the top lane, but Lloyd, oh, actually here in the mid lane, it's gonna be G4, force away the flash as James with the correct timing on that response, saving EXO before he does get into the clutches of G4. So there you go. Like you said, James alleviating the pressure. Interestingly enough, Kaigu actually gonna go in. Lloyd has to respect this guy. Oh, actually no, Kaigu went back for flash.
Yeah, he did change back into the flash in the last second.
I didn't notice.
Champ Select, had he had Ignite, that would have been a kill.
Yeah, I was like, oh my gosh, I thought he had Ignite, where's the burn?
Exactly, but this is, you can see how Viper plays. Viper plays very slow in terms of jungling, while James is crazy aggressive. And you can see right now that the pressure alleviation from mid lane, it now puts G4 on the back foot, because Exosen is running teleport.
Yeah.
He was able to take the trade force the wave into the turret minion, and then minion wave into the turret, and then teleport back. And now he has the EXP advantage, because G4 will be forced to back.
Yeah, plus as well as the mana, so you know G4 can't really do anything too much in the top, in the mid lane. There's gonna be the connection here for Viper, but not gonna be enough. Exo does actually have the ultimate to be able to get back his HP and almost gets a double kill into Viper. Look at this mechanical mid laner from the Philippines showing off his prowess in our game 2.
Again, this is because Viper is not doing as much as he should be. His playstyle, he should change his playstyle up, because they have a time limit to when this comp actually works properly, and they will descale pretty hard.
Oh, that thought Warlock here into the mid lane might actually be trying to just give some support for Viper. I thought he was gonna go aggressive and put some thorns, but not gonna be the case here into the top lane. 40 to 36 CS, a little bit of a lead for Kaigu. So here.
So as you can see, Exosen realizes that he's about to hit level 6, so he goes super aggressive and then knows his limits. He's gonna take the kill. Flash was already burned. Hits level 6 off of this last hit.
Oh, even with the heal from Viper, it wasn't enough. It's too much of a, how do they call this? Like a minuscule heal. So now that's gonna at least give Mineski here the first blood, but there is still that 3,200 gold lead accumulated here by Ascension. That's probably because of the bottom lane
and the jungle.
And the jungle, yeah. just from basically the CS. No so, way though.
It's actually, I find it super interesting that Kaigu hasn't, Kaigu's actually winning the top lane matchup. Based on how the matchup's supposed to go, Kled does win the first few levels, but the moment Fizz hits level 6, Kled's gonna lose out against the Fizz.
Yeah. Maybe it's Lloyd just not knowing the matchup itself, or Kaigu, you know, showing his mechanical prowess as well. Having the timely playful slash trickster, the hops really, you know, detrimenting, I think, the damage potential that Lloyd has in the top lane.
Yeah, one of the things that makes the Fizz versus Kled matchup really good is Fizz has a very small model size, so it's really hard to land that bear trap on a rope.
Yeah.
It's also hard to land your fourth strike of your W. It makes, because Fizz has so much reduced damage from his passive with the Nimble Fighter, and he also has his playful trickster as well to mitigate a ton of damage coming out from Lloyd.
That's true, and if Lloyd is maybe in kill range, he can also use that third skill to actually hop away, or even the first skill if he's, you know, in the away direction.
Exactly. So it's pretty stacked against Lloyd. Lloyd pushed the wave in too early. It was smart because he prevented James from ganking him, but right now it's not working out for him anymore.
That's true. But at least that hasn't translated in terms of the CS. It's still 58-59. Now Viper here into the top lane, setting something up for Lloyd. He does have the ultimate, but at the same time, Kaigu is kind of slippery. Flash almost up. He's going to dash in, but a little bit of harass. But Viper still has no clear shot. The minions in his way. So he has to be a little bit careful. But then at the same time, where is James? Back at base, maybe buying himself more items. Clawfield's hammer and the tracker's... tracker knife, I think. Yep.
So the first gank attempt coming out from Viper, not successful at all. But you can see just by the gold itself, Viper is 400 gold ahead of James. And even though the gold lead is practically zero already, you can still see that there's a really big gold lead between the jungler and the bottom lane of Ascension versus Mineski.
Yeah, but then at the same time, hasn't translated yet to anything, of course. Still have to wait, but here it comes to the bottom lane. No way, has to be flashed as well as healed, but there's a Stranglethorn from Warlock. Look at the auto attacks from Ascension, actually going to be able to pick the ADC of Ascension up. Oh my goodness, Warlock is burning. He's almost about to die. Runs away, but here comes EXO into the bottom lane. Flashes in, dashes in, gets the kill, and he will be able to use that ultimate to get on out of there. G4 slapping him back into the fight. Parallel Convergence trying to get the stun, but not going to be enough damage from Ascension. Too strong still. 2-for-1 trade.
So much aggression coming out from Mineski. The moment TG hits level 6, they go all in. They planned it together with James. They were all on the same page. Even EXO already rotated the moment they started that fight. G4 luckily gets a Straddler kill, but in most situations, Warlock would have died already had Mineski landed.
Just a faster initiation.
Yes, exactly. If they did it a little bit cleaner, they wouldn't have had EXO die.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the reason exactly why they banned out the Lulu. It's just because if you think about it in a defensive sense, Stranglethorns compared to Wild Growths, like in prolonging the life of someone who's targeted by maybe the Nether Grasp of that Malzahar, is just too valuable. And the Stranglethorns isn't enough. I mean, yeah, he got like a 3-man Stranglethorns, but then the chase potential was still on there because, you know, Arcane Shift in, there's the jump of James, and even TG can splash in and maybe, you know, connect some shots. And now they're going to be able, or actually Ascension's still going to be able to get the dragon though.
Yeah, dragons haven't been, the first dragons in this series haven't been contested at all. So So red team always seems to prioritize the dragon first. Next Cloud Drake is also Cloud, so we might see a triple Cloud Drake, double Infernal this game.
What?
To be the alternative of last game.
Oh, but Lloyd here, actually in a bit of trouble, does have at least the extra HP to soak up the damage. James looking actually ripe for the gank there, or for the tower dive, but to no avail. 17k to 70k in terms of the gold. It really isn't looking too out of control here for Ascension. Mineski have been initiating and have been getting the results, and Ascension have been getting the scraps.
Exactly. So Kaigu just uses TP advantage TP back into the top lane, probably looking to freeze.
But hey, it Viper looks here though. I mean, there is an ultimate here, Rono Break for EXO, so he's gonna be able to, you know, just get back that damage unless they have enough lockdown or enough damage output to get that snipe onto him. Prowl Convergence, just a little bit for scouting.
Yeah, but right now we already see the Nether Grasp up. We might see another fight into the bot lane after Zensho backs, because Zensho just uses his ultimate into the lane just to shove the wave in. They might be looking to set up another gank. James is on the right side right here.
That's true. But he is hovering in the mid lane, so it could be a gank onto G4. You have to be still pretty afraid. I mean, Power Convergence does take some time, but then at the same time, if you're that overextended, you might not be able to escape. There we go, 2v1 situation. G4 trying to run away. This is like the slowest chase ever, but he's going to try to re-engage James. Oh my goodness, why did Exil actually leave his jungler to die there? Here comes Lloyd with the teleport, but he won't be able to save G4. Viper on the sidelines, Dragon Pit actually, but he won't be able to leap over and provide some harassment. But here we go, Kled, Lloyd going in. Nobody to follow through. He's just playing Ring Around the Rosie in this stone area. Dives in from EXO. There is the Fizz ultimate getting the knockup. Damage onto Viper is surreal. But then at the same time, here it is. Stranglethorns plus No Ways. Chain of Corruption. And that's going to be the pickoff that I think Ascension were looking for.
A lot of these aggressive plays are calculated, but there are a lot of miscalculations right now.
It's like, why did EXO leave James? I don't know. I mean, was there like a... What's the mindset to that? What do you think was the mindset to that?
I feel like they should have actually committed, hard committed onto G4, but G4 had no reason to actually move that far up into the mid lane.
That's true, but I guess sometimes logic can be outbalanced by mechanical prowess, because that's how G4 does it. Like, you don't think that he was going to be able to get the kill, but then I saw like a match when they were going up against BKT and he was using a Victor that you don't actually think that he's going to get the kill, but he does. But now he's going to do the same thing. He doesn't have a flash anymore, trying to run away. Slaps back EXO. Parallel Conversion will not connect to this guy's. Here comes Lloyd, as well as Viper, so Cavalry has given G4 some backup. And that will just be a little bit of a taste of aggression from Ascension.
But Mineski realizes that Warlock was already roaming from the bottom lane to that skirmish, so they actually back off instead.
Yeah. So I kind of like this from... Wait, hold that thought. James, bit of low in HP. They're just going to be able to seal that blue buff. No! He gets a smite.
James with the smite steals this.
Jump the waters. There's the rabbit. Viper trying to run away. Kaigu still hot on his tracks. Lloyd is actually here. Gonna be able to dash. Leaves his mount, but Nethergrass will finalize the kill. And that's gonna be another pickoff here for the side of Mineski. Maybe the Rift Herald? That's gonna be a no.
TG being first to roam, actually, because Warlock already moved back towards the bottom lane, but instead TG still hard committed to that skirmish because they knew that blue was being stolen by Ascension Gaming.
Yeah. I guess you can actually, maybe even if you can't see Viper, Lloyd, or G4, you can actually have a little bit of indication, because Warlock always roams up when there's going to be some sort of clash there for Ascension. So I think they should at least mix that up, maybe delay his response a little bit, just because it's going to be too obvious for Mineski here. No Way, though, has to use his ultimate so that he will be able to get away from the clutches of EXO, but at the same time, the other members of Ascension are going to be able to get that mid-tier one.
That is actually way more important for Ascension Gaming to get that mid-tier one. Even though Mineski does get the first turret gold, Ascension Gaming still is ahead in gold. And with a red side Varus together with a red side Jace, they can stop any possible Baron attempts coming out from Mineski.
And now EXO actually shifting up to the bottom lane, but he has to be careful. Four members of Ascension are here. Will they actually go in? There's the Grasping Roots. Teleport coming in from Kaigu. He's a little bit too over-aggressive there. Has to back away as he was immediately bursted down to 140 HP as he comes out from the teleport animation. And look at this. Ascension actually getting some value. Look at the top tier one almost taken down by Lloyd.
But Kaigu was able to burn two summoner spells coming out from Ascension, which was the Ignite of the Jace and also the Exhaust coming out from Warlock. So technically two summoners for one, it was still worth it for Mineski to take the trade. But Ascension Gaming take trade top T1 now for their mid T1.
And looks like Ascension are going to be fighting for this mid lane. EXO had to use the Chrono Break. Going to be trying to escape, but here from the silence is no way. He might be a little bit too out of position here, so he has to respect that Mineski actually engage upon him. But that's going to be a no. Warlock does get the Nether Grasp. Here's the Hawk from Hamez. Takes a shutdown onto Viper, and no way has to respect him. Very low in HP. I don't know what's going on. Why is Ascension actually going in low HP onto this one? Four members have gone down already, and G4 is just going to stand and not stand his ground, basically, because he just wanted to for Mineski to get the wipeout.
That was a beautiful play coming out from Mineski, waiting, realizing that Lloyd was on his way. They knew where direction he was coming from and where his ult was targeted, so they actually darted out away from Lloyd. And then the moment his ultimate stopped, they suddenly turned with the parallel convergence. And they take the first dragon plus possible mid T2 as well.
Yeah. Interesting enough, from Warlock, he actually flashed in and tried to connect a grasping root.
Yeah, but super aggressive, as you can see in the team fight.
Yeah, let's check it out.
You have Lloyd coming in, but they already realize that Lloyd's there. Lloyd tries to E over the wall. Warlock, super aggressive. And then the parallel convergence zones them out. Hamez takes out the entire backline of Ascension Gaming. Lloyd cannot do anything because he's in the front line while G4 isn't helping him kill the backline of Mineski.
Yeah, G4 just wanting to give some support to No Way, but No Way was very low in HP already there from, you know, Hamez's assassination attempts. So that's gonna be, well, Mineski getting an 11-4, 2,000 gold lead, and I think a Cloud Drake as well.
And a lot of chunk damage into the mid T1. The mid T2. One of the things that you want to have as a red side Varus and a red side Jace is to not lose your mid tier 2. Because if you lose the mid tier 2, you lose a lot of access to your left side jungle, which then makes it harder for you to defend Baron.
True enough. And now, item check. We're actually going to see a Trinity Force already here for Kaigu. And Kaigu actually going to be activating Chum the Waters. No way, forced to use his heal before Chum the Waters. QSS just to be able to get away. And here's an Endergrass onto Warlock, as well as the Ezreal ultimate. There you go. And another pick off here for Mineski. Catching off Ascension and G4 trying to pick up something. But he's going to be dueling against EXO, who is a little bit too tanky for his taste. Lloyd going to go in, actually overshoots EXO. But here comes Viper. This is just chase down onto EXO with three members of Ascension. Finally, they get the kill. That could have been a little bit too worrisome, as Lloyd kind of overshot.
We also have pings towards Rift Herald when it's about to despawn in 20 seconds. Will they be able to take this in time? Because Hamez and TG are on their way. They spot this out.
Oh, this is not good. G4 is very low in HP, and they are just catching every single out-of-position member here of Ascension. Viper has to run away, but here comes TG. Flashes in, gets the kill, and he is going to be able to deny the Rift Herald as the Baron has summoned himself into the pit. There he is.
But yeah, like, starting Rift Herald at 19:30 isn't exactly the smartest idea, especially when you don't know where most of your enemies are. One of the things you'd have to take note of as Ascension Gaming is that the enemy team is also running a pick comp, and they're executing it better than Team Ascension. The thing is, Lloyd's ultimates haven't connected at all this entire game. All three attempts to land his ultimate, either he overshoots, he falls short, or he just outright missed. And they need Lloyd to start hitting his ultimates so that they can get these really good team fights in.
True enough. And at the same time, you do have to question Ascension for starting these objectives when they don't have the manpower, plus at the same time, they were coming out of a fight. They were injured already in that point. So they had like lower HPs, and when Mineski spotted him out, well, they really can't do too much.
Exactly. And you only had 30 seconds to kill the Rift Herald. They would have made it, but it was too close for comfort.
Yeah, Mineski got a little bit of a sniff of that, and, you know, took a little bit of the action. I mean, it wasn't Rift Herald, but it was kills, so they'll happily get that one for themselves.
They could have gotten the Rift Herald as well if both they turned on the Rift Herald with 2,000 HP and not let it reset. So it could have been worse for Ascension Gaming. Luckily, they didn't. Hamez wasn't able to get the Rift Herald, and, well,
yeah.
Ascension Gaming right now on the clock. They have to pick their fight smart and make sure that they get objectives out of them and not just these random kills.
Yeah. So let's get a little bit back into the item check as I was rudely interrupted by our teams. It's Trinity Force already for Kaigu. There is the TBC for Hames. Mid lane, XO is going to be happy with the Proto Belt as well as the Zonya's Hourglass, but Mineski is going to be starting off the Baron. And Ascension do spot this out. They do have the wardings to actually see right in front of their eyes. Then at the same time, do they have the strength, the team fight power here to force out Mineski? Or even if like Mineski is going to get the last hit on the Baron, can they actually fight for it?
And this is pretty similar to what Ascension Gaming did last game where they ran a...
Okay, Maxo going to be chased down here by G4. He does actually use the Zonya's Hourglass. Does he have the Corona Break? Yes, but his HP is very low. G4 flashing in, dashes away from Maxo. Timewinder. G4, one more auto attack. Warlock, please don't do it! And Warlock's going to get the last hit. KS, kill secured.
Yeah, this is what Ascension Gaming did last game where they have one of their team members split push bottom lane. But what Mineski didn't do last game was they sent another person to actually deal with the split pusher. And you have an Echo split pushing instead of a Fiora, not one of the best split pushers in the game. So G4 being able to capitalize on that punishes EXO. But still, it's going to happen again because EXO still has his teleport up. Kaigu still has his teleport up. We might see a 1-3-1 or a 0-4-1 coming out from Mineski.
So I guess the possible thing here for Ascension to stop that is to either split push themselves or, you know, pick off these split pushes before they do something else in terms of the objectives. G4 looking to actually get this spot tier 1 and just a couple more shots and he will be able to. But the problem is, Hames as well as another teleport, I think it's going to be Kaigu and EXO. This is very aggressive coming in for Mineski, but at the same time, Ascension got a little bit of a sniff of that one. Though this is a 3v2 situation, G4 way out of position here. Here comes EXO. And there you go, that's the kill! And Lloyd activating his ultimate, but didn't do too much for his mid laner. And here comes Mineski once more. Chum the waters onto Viper. The knock-up, the last hit, the kill. 2-0, and maybe even the dragon. It's gonna be a Mountain Drake too.
Ascension has no business whatsoever with the bottom side. They should be playing for these picks instead because they have the stronger pick-up. They have better burst damage coming out from the Nidalee's Javelin Toss and the Empowered Shock Blast coming out from Jace. So they actually can poke out Mineski, but the allocating the Jace to the bottom side when their enemy team has double teleport is very risky. Now they lose their jungler and the Jace is too far away that they can't actually contest this Baron.
They do have a lot of AoE to work with. There's going to be the Chain of Corruption. Lloyd goes in, Strangle Thorns as well, gets a shutdown onto TG. X is on very low in HP, but there you go. That's going to be the Baron here for the side of Mineski. Here comes G4, finally the Cavalry has arrived. Goes in with the Shock Blast. Look at that. It's going to be a buffet in the Baron pit, but every single member of Mineski actually going over. And now Chase comes here from Ascension. Double kill for Lloyd. G4 spotting out Kaigu. There's going to be a Chum the Waters, but he can't go in. Too much damage output coming in from Ascension here. And will they actually chase, spot out either Kaigu or Zensha? That's going to be a no, but Baron goes to Mineski. Lots of the kills go to Ascension.
Lloyd's Kled actually baited Hames and Exocet out of the Baron pit. As you can see, it's a very beautiful ultimate setup coming out from Ascension Gaming. They were able to kill TG outright even before the Baron was taken. And then as you can see, Lloyd does hop over the pit. But then Exocet and Hames being greedy, landing the pocket pistol and gets the kill onto Hames. Exo then goes in as well because G4 is chasing him. Tries to kill Lloyd, but Lloyd is just way too tanky.
Yeah, he had that bait extra HP coming out. I mean, it's like super low. One, like, breeze of a bullet and he would have died. But then, nah.
Skarl being the MVP there.
So bait potential here, and it's going to be another aggressive take in here by Ascension. Hames is way out of position. It's going to be the jungler taken down. Nether grasp of TG, but it's not going to be enough. Kaiga going in, falls deep into the opposing team, but will he actually get the kill? On to No Way. That's going to be a yes, but at the same time, look at Lloyd as well as Viper taking down the core members of Mineski. Kaiga the only one to remain as well as EXO, but can they re-engage or will they just look at Ascension and say, hey guys, you took our members, you took some, but it looks like you won.
Yeah, so as we were talking about earlier, Lloyd needs to land his ultimates. When he lands his ultimates, they win team fights because they can force 5v4s like that where EXO was still doing something in the in their left side jungle. They were able to catch four members of Mineski out and win the fight 3-1.
Yeah.
But they haven't translated it to anything, but it still slows down Mineski in terms of their ramping up.
And I guess that like cherry on top of the pick off Sunday that Ascension had was, you know, they got the Gene of Corruption onto, I believe that was James.
Yeah.
So, you know, getting off this, taking out this Kha'Zix is definitely a good pick off starter for Ascension.
But there's still two Baron buffs for Mineski, but still, that fight actually helped them stall the game out a little bit longer by delaying any kind of slow push setup coming out from Mineski.
And with that in mind, it looks like Ascension, they kind of lost a little bit in the mid game. And it was also shown in the gold, but now it's kind of neck and neck. Three towers to three. Two dragons for Mineski. That's going to be the Cloud Drake and Mountain. And Ascension here does have the Cloud, but in terms of who does have the faster trigger, it's been showing recently for the side of Ascension with the help from Lloyd's Ultimate.
So now you can see that Warlock is fighting for Vision Control over Dragon being the next objective. They need to secure the Vision Control so that Mineski will be going in blind and Ascension Gaming will have the upper hand to force a fight.
Yeah, and we could, even if we did say that, you know, Ascension will drop somewhat, it's not showing too much right now just because they have that 5v4 situation in these recent fights.
Aside from that, just remember how dominant they were in the laning phase. It still transitions to the gold lead. Even though Mineski is 4 kills ahead, it doesn't matter because of how high the CS discrepancies are.
Actually, that's true.
All lanes are actually ahead or equal right now for Ascension Gaming.
Yeah. Just a low. Only checking the ADC, it's Zensho versus the 40 plus CS advantage of No Way.
Dragon. And you also have two items completed already. Two and a half items completed for No Way compared to Zensho's two and a half items as well. But Iceborne Gauntlet being the choice for the Ezreal instead. We might.
Yeah, it's not too damage heavy, but here into the top lane, Axel gonna be chased down by Lloyd. He's gonna be very aggressive here as TG as well. Zensho actually going over the line of behind enemy lines to maybe get the catch off onto the top lane of Ascension, but then at the same time, you have to see that Ascension were responding too quickly. They have to back off and respect that they might be biting off more than they can chew.
Yeah, so you can see that they're now backing just in time for the Dragon Timers, forcing Ascension to play to the tune, having to set up waves in the top lane and in the bottom lane, making Lloyd's back timer super awkward. So he'll have a lot of gold up, but he needs to back first to actually get more items. So he has a choice whether he should back now and then force his TP or his charge into the dragon pit.
It looks like he's gonna check or use the ladder, choose the ladder and join his team. As he'll be getting himself a chain vest. Dragon taking quite a bit of poke here from Ascension. And Mineski onto the bottom side of the Dragon River. Teleport being commenced here by Exo. Here it comes. Nether grass, but oh my goodness! Stranglethorn swells Chain of Corruption, just decimating the members of Mineski. Two straight kills for No Way. And it's going to be Exo trying to go into the black line. G4 as well as Viper, very low in HP. But at the same time, Lloyd is onto the side, maybe dealing the damage though. Even though the fight actually went in favor early on for Ascension, they got too much damage from Mineski, and Mineski are actually cleaning up 3-2.
Yeah, that was a really good fight. It was a really good fight set up by Ascension. Oh, a Straggler kill coming out from G4 gets Exosen in the mid lane. But again, it was a really good setup coming out from Ascension, but Faigu wasn't there at the start of the fight, so they didn't act. It was again a 5v4. That's what Ascension won. But when it became a full-on 5v5, Mineski actually pulls on through. Ascension Gaming, they lack this sustained damage that Mineski has because they have an Ezreal. They have
Let's actually check out the fight because I'm really curious how Ascension, the prime members, actually got too much damage in their carries.
So as you can see, James takes all of the frontline damage, all of the burst coming out from Ascension. But remember that Mineski has way better sustained damage coming out from a super tanky Fizz. They have Exo. Exo gets the kill onto No Way. Kaigu for some reason thought that Warlock was still there. Zensho super aggressive, flashes in.
And he does get the finalized kill on the Viper. Not too good, but look at this. There's going to be Ascension coming back at it again with two kills. And Mineski, now this time, cannot actually go for their despawn.
Yeah, so Mineski probably was trying to get vision control of the left side jungle of the red team. Sadly, they got caught out by Team Ascension Gaming.
Yeah, again, that's just, you know, Ascension's, I guess, playstyle as their comp dictates. If you're a little bit out of position, where you just initiate and you really can't respond to that, and that's where they get these kills. Kaigu gonna be in the top lane, spotting on Viper, but will he engage? I think that's gonna be a no. He's gonna have to respect that this is still the territory of Ascension.
Especially with the composition of Ascension Gaming, you overstep, they can punish you immediately with the Kled ult. They have the Chains of Corruption. They have Warlock as well with the Flash Root. It's really scary right now. And Mineski, using both TPs for that dragon fight, do not have teleport advantage.
Look at EXO getting depleted there just by G4's auto-attacks. He actually uses the Zonius, but then will it be enough? Oh my goodness, he uses Soul Demon, but then TG gets caught up. Zensho gets caught up here. Here comes Floyd from the sidelines, and that's going to be a double kill for Viper. James can only see his teammates fall all around him. Mid-tier 2 taken down, and now Ascension are knocking into the mid-tier 3. Power of Mineski knocking onto the base, and will Mineski actually answer? That's gonna be a no. It gets taken down, and the inhibitor is exposed. Kaigu doing the best that he can, but he is just a fish, or I don't know, an Easter egg, an Easter bunny fish, whatever you want to call him, trying to defend, but it's not enough. And looks like Ascension are wanting to end this fight once and for all for game two, but will they? Kaigu is doing actually a sufficient job of at least being somewhat of a defender here for the last turret on that Nexus.
Yeah, Ascension actually overstaying it, but they did get one Nexus turret. It was okay. It was really scary though, because if they did get collapsed on by Mineski, but luckily the death timers was just way too long.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they were looking at the death timers. And my goodness,
the chain of events.
Yeah, I mean, EXO, he just wanted to survive for as long as possible, but then at the same time, when he Chrono break out, TG was so exposed, and then it was Zensho on the bottom side of that mid tier 2, spotted out by No Way, and he just, like, you know, ultied him, and then they just got three follow-up kills that just led them so much.
But you now, can see Baron started already, but
Lloyd activated the ultimate, Parallel Converge is connected up onto him, EXO gets the last hit onto the Baron, but the damage too much onto Mineski here! There's gonna be at least the ultimate used by EXO, but two of them have faltered now. G4 with the chase, that's gonna be the acceleration, they're actually giving Mineski, or Ascension rather, lots of chase potential here. Viper just pouncing in, getting the kills, and only James is left as the smoke clears, as the dust clears. The problem is, that is 30 seconds average on four members of Mineski. James is the only one to defend.
James trying to pull the minion wave away from Warlock and the rest of the Ascension squad, but James won't work for him, and gets the executioner kill, but some KDA padding for the game.
But
that's already game for Ascension Gaming.
Oh my goodness. Mineski tried to get the Baron in before Ascension could actually respond to it, but then Lloyd's ultimate just gives them so much gap closer.
Yeah, especially when Lloyd started landing his ultimate, that was when the script was flipped. That's, and Ascension Gaming started winning the
game. That's when it got real for Ascension, man.
Yeah, like when Lloyd started landing those ults, starting those fights 5v4 against Mineski, even they weren't able to take down the two members. Remember, after that replay, they were able to take two members. Then they started taking EXO and TG in the mid lane.
Yeah.
It all started from there, with Lloyd actually getting the momentum, I guess.
I guess he was just like adjusting to how aggressive Mineski were playing. Plus, and then maybe he wasn't accustomed to the Kled pick into Kaigu's Fizz. But then, you know, once they kind of ended the laning phase, once they got into the team fight phase, or, you know, objective phase, that's when he found the openings. That's when Ascension came together and then just got all things correct in their, I guess, in their win condition.
Exactly. Yeah. It was really scary the way they started that fight for that second Mountain Drake, where they allocated both TPs coming out from Mineski's side. Those double TPs used in that fight caused them to lose their TP advantage, letting Lloyd split push the bottom lane while his four teammates were busy catching out EXO in the mid lane. Lloyd then, having his ultimate, could straight up charge into the mid lane to help his teammates while Kaigu was still in the top lane. So just the miscalculation of resources allocated for that dragon. They should have backed earlier and should have prepared for that second Mountain Drake in time to not actually waste their double TP.
Yeah, that catch off into mid lane really wrecked it for Mineski as their inhibitor was exposed and they were kind of short on what options they had to go for. I think like one of them was the Baron. They tried to, but again, Lloyd's ultimate too fast for the gap closer, so no luck there. So guys, there you have it. Game 2 already done. One more, and it's going to be Ascension going to the finals on Sunday. I mean, can Mineski go for the reverse sweep, or will they just allow Ascension to run rampant in this best of five?
Maybe it's time to change play styles, change player maybe, bring in Nyxta. Yeah, because Nyxta has been one of the junglers for Mineski that helped them reverse sweep against IPT. So Mineski not new to reverse sweeps as well.
So maybe
but Ascension
is,
Gaming, they just have to keep their feet on the ground, their heads on the ground as well, because they are performing really well. That if they just do what they're already doing, they actually played the red side Varus way better than Mineski as well, where they don't actually start the Baron and instead just wait for Mineski to start the Baron and then punish them while they're doing Baron.
Yeah, so be sure to stay tuned, guys. Game 3 will be underway in a couple of minutes. Again, I'm Asurai here with Iconic, and you're watching the Garena Premier League 2017. So we'll see you in a bit. As well as Heal, but there's a Stranglethorns from Warlock. Look at the auto attacks from Sancho. Actually going to be able to pick the ADC of Ascension up. Oh my goodness, Warlock is burning. He's almost about to die. Runs away, but here comes EXO into the bottom lane. Flashes in, dashes in, gets the kill, and he will be able to use that ultimate to get on out of there. G4 slapping him back into the fight. Pyro fighting for this mid lane. EXO had to use the Chrono Break. Gonna be trying to escape, but here from the silence is no way. He might be a little bit too out of position here, so he has to respect that Mineski actually engage upon him, but that's gonna be a no. Warlock does get the nether grasp. Here's the hop from Hamas. Takes a shutdown onto Viper, and no way has to respect him. Very low in HP. I don't know what's going on. Why is Ascension actually going in low HP onto this one? Four members have gone down already, and G4 is just very low in HP, and they are just catching every single out of position member here of Ascension. Viper has to run away, but here comes TG. Flashes in, gets the kill, and he is going to be able to deny the Rift Herald as the Baron has summoned himself into the pit. There he is. Same time, Ascension got a little bit of a sniff of that one, though this is a 3v2 situation. G4 way out of position here. Here comes EXO, and there you go, that's the kill. And Lloyd activating his ultimate, but didn't do too much for his mid laner. And here comes Mineski once more, chum the waters onto Viper, the knock up, the last hit, the kill to work with. There's going to be the Chain of Corruption. Lloyd goes in, Stranglethorns as well, gets a shutdown onto TG. Excellent, very low in HP, but there you go, that's going to be the Baron here for the side of Mineski. Here comes G4, finally the cavalry has arrived, goes in with the Shock Blast. Look at that, it's going to be a buffet in the Baron pit, but every single member of Mineski actually going over, and now Chase comes here from Ascension. Double kill for Lloyd. G4 spotting out Kaigu. There's going to be a chunk of waters, but he can't go in too much damage. Be another aggressive take in here by Ascension. Have his way out of position. It's going to be the jungler taken down. The other grasp on TG, but it's not going to be enough. Kaigu going in, falls deep into the opposing team. But will he actually get the kill? On to No Way. That's going to be a yes, but at the same time, look at Lloyd as well as Viper taking down the core members of Mineski. Kaigu, the only one to remain
as well here by EXO.
Here it comes. Nether grasp, but oh my goodness, Stranglethorn swells Chain of Corruption, just decimating the members of Mineski. Two straight kills for No Way, and it's going to be EXO trying to go into the black line. G4 as well as Viper, barely low in HP, but at the same time, Lloyd is on to the side, maybe dealing the damage, though. Even though the fight actually went in favor early on for Ascension, they got too much damage from Mineski, and Mineski are actually cleaning
up. Activated the ultimate, Pyro Converges connected up onto him. EXO gets the last hit onto the Baron,
but the damage too much onto Mineski here. There's gonna be at least the ultimate used by EXO, but two of them have faltered now. G4 with the chase, that's gonna be the acceleration. They're actually giving Mineski, or Ascension rather, lots of chase potential here. Viper just pouncing in, getting
the... Oh my goodness.
Mineski tried to get the Baron in before Ascension could actually respond to it, but then no.